Good morning, dear students. In the last video lecture on vectors, I discussed with you people about vector addition, and thereafter I discussed that vector addition is of course not possible by simple laws of algebra. For vectors, you cannot do 10 plus 7 equals to 17. No. You need to know the directions also, because it could be 10 minus 7 equals to 3 also. So you need to know the directions in which the vectors are acting. And thereafter, I taught about triangle law of vector addition, parallelogram law of vector addition. And today I am going to discuss the special cases of triangle law and parallelogram law. So how to go about it? First of all, let's have a brief recall of what triangle law is and what parallelogram law is. In triangle law, I told you people that if there is A vector, then there is B vector. They both are represented by two sides of a triangle which are taken in same order. You can see that A vector, B vector, they are taken in same order. So their, you know, resultant, their overall effect will be represented by the third side of the triangle, which is not taken in the same order. You can see that this is some order going on, P to Q, Q to S. It should be S to P, but no, the resultant is from P to S. Okay, so, and the resultant is written as A vector plus B vector. Then I taught you about parallelogram law. If two vectors have same origin, like we have A vector, we have B vector, and then what we do? We just complete the parallelogram, and the diagonal of that parallelogram is going to give us the resultant. Again, the resultant is the overall effect of these two vectors. So we would write it as R vector equals to A vector plus B vector. And then we discussed that whether it is triangle law, whether it is parallelogram law, both of them have the same magnitude of resultant, which is equal to under the root A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta, where theta refers to the angle between A vector and B vector. And what about the direction of R vector? Like if R vector makes an angle beta with A vector, then the direction we used to calculate as tan beta equals to B sine theta divided by A plus B cos theta. Here, beta is that angle which the resultant makes with A vector, and theta is that angle which is there in A vector and B vector. Okay. So case number one, the special case number one, when two vectors are acting in same direction, A vector and B vector, they both are acting in same direction. So if this is happening, theta equals to zero, because theta means the angle between A vector and B vector. Right now, right here, you can see that they both are acting in same direction, so it would not be wrong to say that they are sharing an angle of 0 degree with each other. So if they are sharing an angle of 0 degree with each other, so let me carry out the further investigations. Let me just see what is the resultant now, what is the direction of resultant now. So I'll be putting the values in the standard results. Standard result number one, magnitude of R, A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. Rather, I would be writing 2AB cos 0 degree. 2AB cos 0 degree. Cos 0 degree is 1. You know that. So, I'll be writing 1 over here. So, this would be under the root A square plus B square plus 2AB under the root A plus B whole square. You know it better than me, because it's a mathematical identity. A plus B whole square equals to A square plus B square plus 2AB, right? And when this square is under the root, the square goes it cancels and r equals to a plus b. But do you know what this r is? The magnitude of the resultant, and it is coming out to be equal to the sum of the magnitudes of a vector and b vector. Do you know what does it mean? That if two vectors are acting along the same direction, they are added up. They are added up. I'm applying a force of 10 newtons to push some object. Someone else is here. He's applying 20 newtons to push that same object. Since we both are applying the forces in the same direction, so our forces are going to add up to give eventually 30 newtons to push that object. So that's what it means. Okay. And what will happen when two vectors are acting in opposite direction? When two vectors are acting in opposite directions. Just give me a second. Okay. So if A vector is directed along here, B vector is directed along here. Okay. So this time A vector and B vector both are sharing an angle of 180 degrees with each other. Like A vector is in this direction, B vector is in this direction. So they both are sharing an angle of 180 degrees with each other. So let me put this value in the standard result. Standard result is R equals to under the root A square plus B square plus 2AB cos 180 degree, and cos 180 degree is equal to minus 1. Cos 180 degree is equals to minus 1. So R equals to under the root A square plus B square minus 2AB. So this becomes R equals to A minus B whole square. So R equals to A minus B. So this means when two vectors are acting in the opposite directions, so to find out the overall magnitude, you need to subtract the lower vector from the bigger vector. As an example, if you have some object over here, someone is applying a force of 30 newtons over here and someone here is applying a force of 10 newtons. You know what? The overall effect is 20 newtons, because 10 newtons here will be cancelled with 10 newtons of 30 newtons, and we are left with 20 newtons only, which are acting along this direction. So remember that when two vectors are acting in opposite directions, the overall resultant will act along bigger vector. Okay, uska direction wahi hoga jo bigger vector ka hoga. And eventually what will happen? Its value will be equal to, magnitude will be equal to bigger vector minus lower vector. In case, it could also be B minus A if B is greater than A. So remember that. Okay, in the previous case that I taught you, I need to discuss the direction also here. In the previous case that I had taught you, what would be the direction? The direction would be the same. If you see, you would have to calculate the direction also. Though we know that the direction is along here, but you have to give a mathematical proof to us. So, tan beta equals to, you need to put the values, B sine 0 degree upon A plus B cos 0 degree. Sine 0 degree is 0. So, tan beta equals to 0. Tan beta equals to 0. So beta is equal to 0. Very simple. So pehli baat to, if tan beta equals to 0, beta equals to 0, why? Because it is the value of tan 0 degree, and tan goes with tan, and we are left with beta equals to 0. Why am I telling you this? This is very, very important, because cos theta or cos alpha, if this is 0, then alpha is not equal to 0, students. Okay. Aisa nahi hota ki if this value is 0, so alpha is also equal to 0. No. Because if cos alpha is 0, 0 ki value kya hoti hai? Cos 90 degree, cos ki terms mein. If you remember it, cos 90 is 0 na, sine 0, cos 0 degree is 1, cos 90 is 0. So then cos with go with cos and alpha will become equal to 90 degree. So every time the case is different. So try to solve it logically. Okay. So anyway, this was the first case where I have calculated the direction as beta equals to 0 degree. Beta equals to 0 degree, which means whatever, see beta वो angle होता है जो resultant A vector के साथ बनाता है. तो A vector के साथ वो कोई angle नहीं बना रहा, 0 degree, यानी resultant भी इसी direction में act कर रहा है. वो मुझे पहले ही पता था, if two people are pushing this thing over here, resultant is also acting along here only. But we need to prove it mathematically. So next is this. Here also tan beta equals to B sin theta upon A plus B cos theta. So here also you need to put 180 degree in place of theta. So you either have, see, you have tan beta equals to 0. Okay, so either the angle is 0 degree or 180 degree, the resultant will always act along the bigger vector. If bigger vector is B vector, then the resultant will act along B vector. If the bigger vector is A vector, the resultant will act along A vector. The last case, if theta equals to 90 degree, which means the two vectors that are acting, they are perpendicular to each other. So theta equals to 90 degree. In that case, what you will be doing, R is equal to under root A square plus B square plus 2AB cos 90. And cos 90 is 0. So this term is vanished. And you will be left with under root A square plus B square. And what would be the direction? Tan beta equals to B sin 90 upon A plus B cos 90. Cos 90 is 0. So this term is vanished. Sin 90 is 1. So we will be left with B by A. So beta will be equal to, take it here, tan inverse B by A. So these are the special cases of triangle law and parallelogram law.